Hi, FBC kids, welcome back. Now, before we get into our story today, I want you to get your activity page out and connect a line in the close-up picture to where they belong in the big picture. So pause this video now and pull that out. In today's Bible story, King Nebuchadnezzar had a dream about a tree. The king did not know what the dream meant, so he found someone to tell him its meaning. Let's listen to the Bible story to hear who told King Nebuchadnezzar what his dream meant. But before we get to that, let's play a game. So I'm going to show some pictures of different animals, and I want you to show me with actions where they lived. So for example, if I showed you a picture of a bird, I want you to pretend to be a giant tree where the bird lives. And if I show a picture of a dog, I want you to jump down and touch the ground to where a dog would be. And if I show a picture of a fish, I want you to pretend to swim in the ocean or a lake. Okay, are you ready? Let's go. In today's Bible story, King Nebuchadnezzar had a dream about a big, strong tree. Now, the tree had beautiful leaves and fruit, and animals lived in and around the tree. None of the king's wise men could tell him what the dream meant, but Daniel could. So let's listen to today's Bible story so we can hear what King Nebuchadnezzar's dream was all about. The Bible is God's word, and the stories in it are true. Today's Bible story is from the book of Daniel. It's in the Old Testament part of the Bible.
Hi friends, it's me, Megan, and I'm Jessie. Megan, listen to the dream I had last night.
Okay.
I dreamed that I was swimming, but it wasn't water I was swimming in. It was a huge bowl of gravy.
Wow, Jessie, that's a strange dream.
Yeah, I woke up hungry for some cheesy blueberry mashed potatoes with gravy.
Okay, well guess what? In today's Bible story, King Nebuchadnezzar had a strange dream too.
King Nebuchadnezzar? What kind of name is that for a king? Did he invent cheddar cheese? Do I have him to thank for the cheese in my cheesy blueberry mashed potatoes? I love them.
No, King Nebuchadnezzar.
King Nebuchadnezzar.
closer, but no. King Nebuchadnezzar. You know what? I've got an idea. Why don't you keep practicing while we listen to the Bible story?
Okay.
Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon, shared a message about the wonderful things God had done for him. One night, the king had a scary dream. He asked the wise men in his kingdom to tell him what the dream meant, but the wise men did not know. So the king told Daniel about his dream. I saw a big, strong tree. Its top was in the sky, and everyone could see it. The tree had beautiful leaves and fruit, and animals lived in and around the tree. An angel came down from heaven and said, "Cut down the tree." Only the stump and roots would be left. Then the angel said something strange. The tree's mind would change from a human's mind into an animal's mind. He said this would happen so that people would know God is ruler over everyone, even kings. The dream made Daniel feel afraid too, and he told the king what it meant. "The tree is you. You are great and strong," Daniel said. Like the tree was cut down, you will go away from people. You will live with wild animals and eat grass. Like the stump was left in your ground, your kingdom will not be completely destroyed. It will be given back to you when you learn that God rules over everything. 1 year later, the king's dream came true. He walked on the roof of his palace and said, "My kingdom is great. I am powerful and wonderful." Suddenly, the king heard a voice from heaven. "King Nebuchadnezzar, you will go away from people. You will live with wild animals and eat grass until you learn that God rules over everything." Nebuchadnezzar went away from people. He ate grass like a cow. His hair grew long like eagle's feathers, and his nails grew sharp like birds' claws. After some time, the king looked up to the sky and praised God. He had learned that God rules over everything. His kingdom was given back to him, and the king worshiped God. Pride is thinking you are great. God showed the king that only God is truly great. Jesus is the King of Kings who came to earth and died on the cross. Jesus saves sinners so we can show others that he is greatest of all.
God wanted King Nebuchadnezzar to understand that only God is truly great. King Nebuchadnezzar learned that God is greatest of all. Jesus is the King of Kings. No earthly king could ever be as great as King Jesus. Jesus came to earth and died on the cross. King Jesus saved sinners so that we can show others that he is greatest of all. Now our key passage comes from 1 Thessalonians 5:17 to 18. Pride is thinking that you're great. People who are prideful forget that they need God and that everything good they have comes from God. We need God every moment of every day. Our key passage reminds us to pray every moment of every day and to give thanks to God in everything. Daniel told King Nebuchadnezzar what God wanted him to learn. Daniel trusted that what God said he would do. Everything Daniel told the king about the dream happened the way God said it would. Daniel trusted God. we can trust God, that God hears us when we talk to Him. So why do we pray? We pray because we trust God and we know that He hears us. Before you guys go and do some more fun activities, let's take some time to pray together, okay? God, we thank you for your word. It is so special that we get to know you by reading the Bible. Thank you for the story of Nebuchadnezzar's dream and how you showed that you are in control of everything. You are powerful and mighty, God. We give you all the praise. Amen.